What is up, everyone? This is Crypto God, and it's 20th of August, and there's a lot of interesting things that's going on in the market. So what we're going to be explaining is, of course, the overall crypto market. We got some secret news of what's going on in the Bitcoin USD charts on a long-term basis, so that's the weekly and the monthly, and of course what happened to the Federal Reserve last night, where Jerome Powell spoke, I think around 1 p.m. UK time. And of course, lastly, we have some Cardano news and why it will be one of the strongest things in DeFi. So if you think that's interesting, what I think you should do is smash the subscribe button and of course click the bell notification. All right, that being said, let's get it started. So, over the past week or so, I've called out in my Telegram group that I won't be investing. And this was when the Bitcoin price was around 11,800, 11,900. And I said, hey, there's no point investing. There's no point you putting in big bags. Of course, you can still always dollar cost average, but I said, there's no point putting any huge significant orders and buying because you're just going to be at a loss. And guess what? I was right. Lord and behold, I was correct. Everyone said, thank you. We took your advice, blah, blah, blah. Obviously, it's non-financial advice. You don't listen to anything I say. But hey, anyways, Bitcoin today is up in the green. It's hovering around 11,300, 11,450. Ethereum 391, XRP down, Tether, Chainlink is down, Bitcoin Cash down, Litecoin. I think I'm missing something. Where is Polkadot? Anyway, there's meant to be Polkadot here somewhere. It's meant to be after Chainlink. But anyways, then you got Crypto.com, Bitcoin Cash, where's Cardano? Cardano's number 12. Hey, I'm still bullish about Cardano. Then you got Tezos, Stellar, yeah. Anyway, all that is interesting. I mean, there's not much going on. I mean, there's a lot to be said about what's going on with the prices. But hey, the values are high, but the prices are not showing that. But eventually, the prices will show that. Anyways, let's go to the Bitcoin charts. And hey, I was speaking to my Telegram group that, hey, guys, I found something really interesting. And what I gotta do, forget these charts, by the way, these charts ain't really interesting, they're just me doodling around, seeing what's going on. Anyways, what's interesting is, of course, the RSI on a monthly. So if I just put that on a monthly, you see this? This was the high of, well, let's just say December/January, somewhere around here. And look at here. Of course, it's not the most perfect graph because then I have to just do this. But you see the correlation? Do you see this? Does anyone see this? Look. This is where it is. Look, it's becoming the same as before. Nothing's changed. It looks the same. Anyways, that being said, I mean, the RSI is very similar to what you've seen in 2017. And of course, here I've got a Fibonacci retracement since dawn of time. And everything matches perfectly to, of course, the Fibonacci levels on a weekly scale, I believe. Yes. There you go. Much better. But hey. And then, of course, everyone's been forgetting about the hash rate. I'm just going to bring this larger. The hash rates are still fine. We're still seeing all-time, well, not really all-time highs, because around the 17th, so it was around, like, 17th of August, we were higher. Now we're just peaking lower. But the good thing is that this is also peaking lower, so it won't be touching for a capitulation phase. But overall, the crypto market is very healthy. I mean, I do expect a strong pullback all the way to the 21 moving average, which is around 10,800, which I haven't got it here, but it's around here, which basically is in perfect alignment with one of these, So it will probably be touching around right here. Bounce here. If it breaks down, we break lower, which I don't see that happening, but hey, it's a possibility. And then of course we will be shooting all the way up to 13,000. 13,000, yeah, around this area, because hey, we got a Fibonacci retracement here as well, so that's going to be resistance. So around 13,000 here, or maybe 12,900 ish. Anyways, that's enough of the charts. I mean, there's not much to talk about, but let's talk about what happened yesterday. Federal Reserve flexible inflation monetary policy could boost Bitcoin price as investors stock up on a Bitcoin safe haven. Wow, that this was really interesting. Now, the most part that you have to take away from what Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell said is what he said here. To prevent this outcome and the adverse dynamics that could ensue, our new statement indicates that we will seek to achieve inflation that averages 2% over time. Therefore, following periods when inflation has been running below 2%, appropriate monetary policy will be likely aimed to achieve inflation moderately above 2% for some time. Now, what does this mean? Well, what this means is that if we look back in the history of the Federal Reserve, that we've been seeing, you can fact check this, by the way. 2011, we saw an inflation of 3%. And then, of course, 2012, 13, 14, it was around a percentage. And now, so far that we're like halfway through 2020, a little bit more than halfway, we're at 1% already. Now, when he says averages, this means that it can go higher, very high. So we might even see 3-4% inflation. And then a year, the next year, it might be just 1%, 1.5%, something like that. But the average should always be close to 2%. So that could be 2.5% or 2.4% on average on a whatever scale. Well, they don't really have much talking about it. They're not really saying, oh, do we have a plan? They have no formula. They're just saying, hey, we're just going to print money and see what happens. That is exactly what he said. If you watch the video, he has said, we will let time decide what will happen. That clearly means that, hey, I've got no clue what's going on. But hey, we're just going to still print because everything looks great. Because we love printing. But anyway, this is just overall good for the crypto market. And of course, gold and silver and all these silver precious metals. It's great. Let me tell you why it's great. Obviously, we never expected the Bitcoin price to go up, I don't know, 20,000 after his speech. Why? Because it takes time. Things like this, for these markets to evaluate what's going on, it has to take time. It has to say, hey, we can see that something's wrong here. We need to increase our price. That's how it basically was like dumbing it down. It takes time. Maybe the price will reflect on what he said next year. Maybe maximum 2 or 3 years, but I would say next year because things are too bullish. And lastly, we'll be going to the Cardano news because we haven't been speaking about Cardano much. We know we've been really bullish about what's going on here. And of course, I've been even looking at the coding from Cardano, and hey, it's looking really, 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 really great. Anyway, Cardano will be extremely competitive in DeFi space with upcoming Goguen rollout. Now, for all those that you don't know, what is Goguen? Goguen is like smart contract. Let me just dumb it down to smart contracts. That's what it is. That's the next phase. But hey, expected to launch in September. Okay, I thought it was being expected to be launching November/December, but hey, even better, September price rises. Anyway, what is Goguen? What can we expect from Goguen? Now, Goguen is really, really complicated, but hey, it's very friendly in approach to people who are going to be making on top of Cardano. So let me tell you, it says it right here. So the native assets takes Cardano from a single asset ledger to a multi-asset ledger. The Plutus Foundation takes the extended unspent transaction output and the Plutus model into Cardano. This means that smart contracts can now fully be programmable experience. The Plutus application frame leverages 35 years of best practices and knowledge in the Haskell ecosystem, as explained by Cardano founder Charles Hoskinson. Now, what it means is that, hey, we're going to have three types of smart contracts. Well, it's not really three types. It's one way of doing it, but it has a multi-asset ledger. But hey, we would go for an application that is best for practices. So like he says here, which I'm just going to quote here, once you have these three things, we're extremely competitive for DeFi. There will be a lot of cool things that will make Cardano the desired platform for a beautiful DeFi portfolio. And hey, Hoskinson then explains that 2020 is going to be close, very strong. It's going to close very strong. 2020 is going to close very strong. Yes, I was correct. 2021 is going to open up and is going to be a clash of the titans. There's a lot of great competitors out there like Polkadot, Tezos, EOS, and Algorand. But we have a great strategy, and people are going to be really excited to be building on a 35 years of legacy and with some of the brightest computer scientists in the world. Hey, I'm really bullish. I was always bullish about Cardano. I'm not trying to shield the coin, but hey, you should grab some Cardano if you don't have some. But and then again, let's be transparent. Do I have Polkadot? No. Do I have Tezos? Yes. Do I have EOS? No. And Algorand? No. But hey, if I could, I'll be investing in Polkadot at the lows and Algorand at the lows. But hey, overall, I'm really bullish about Cardano, and I can't wait to hear more stuff in the future. But anyways, guys, this was the news, this was the charts, and this was the market. So if you found that interesting, if you found everything I said interesting for today, I say you should just hit the like button, and of course don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell notifications. Lastly, I mainly post my charts on my free Telegram group that is found below in the description. Just click it. There's not many people. It's a small community, but hey, it is a VIP community. I do say great things, and everyone out there is thankful. And of course, there's no sponsors or me saying, hey guys, download this or download that. And of course, I'm very transparent, so I can speak to all of you viewers as well. Anyways, everyone, have a great afternoon, have a great evening, have a great morning, have a great day in general, and I'll see you next week. Bye.